There was a couple days scanning boilers where the scanner got so hot and started shutting down. So now, you know, 140 degrees next to a boiler, you're trying to scan. Those days kind of suck. Yeah.
My name is Drew Edwards. I'm the Director of Construction Technology for Enerfab.
Shortly after being hired, he moved into the estimating manager role and had this idea that rather than to continue on with the way that we've always done it, let's embrace technology and work more efficiently.
I believe it was Aaron Landolt that came to me and said, hey, we'd like you to take on this initiative to start pushing our technology further. And technology in construction is something that I think is very important, especially now in our current market. So I was excited about the challenge.
We've made an investment in construction technology, and Drew Edwards is leading that initiative where we've been able to utilize laser scanning in more than just going and measuring things. We're using it for pre-construction planning, we're using it for estimating, and I think it's going to make us better and more consistent, more precise in how we do our work.
Let's go to work. So today we're using laser scanning for as-builts on a job where we're almost done in this room putting in new electrical conduit and raceway. And we just want to document everything that we've installed on the site and be able to turn that over in one file to the owner instead of a lot of hand-drawn sketches of what was done to your facility. So the benefit in my mind is immediate on the owner's side.
Laser scanning is a technology that uses time of flight measurement along with 3D photography to create what they call point clouds, which is essentially a 3D model of an environment.
The technology aspects of construction and the markets that we serve is going to see massive shifts over the next probably 3 to 5 years, and we want to be on the front end of that.
The things he's doing with 3D laser scanning now are phenomenal. We were able to be on a call with an owner and an engineer and get pipe routings approved in an existing facility in a matter of about 2 hours, rather than bringing people from all over the country, going to that site, actually physically walking the site. He was able to fly the model through it and overlay the pipe routing into it and get their approval, which allowed us to start fabrication immediately.
This is one we created for developing rigging plans for a boiler project at a local power plant. We wanted to show our client how we were going to place our crane, where we're going to install temporary steel that you're seeing up here, and then how those modules would be lifted by the crane, transferred to the steel, trolleyed into their boiler. It starts painting the picture of all the work you have to do to accomplish that scope.
My first project, I took an assignment going to night shift. I guess it showed some people that I was ready for the challenge.
You know, I came from a construction-based family. My dad was in construction, and he was out building power plants my whole childhood. So when it came time to go to school, I decided to pursue an engineering degree in construction management. I spent 1 year estimating and then was out into the field for the next 8 years, bouncing around the country. At that point, I had come back to Kansas City to pursue a job change where I could stay in one place and be a part of my kid's life.
When Drew came on board, it was very apparent from my first couple interactions with him that we hadn't even began to tap his full potential.
He can talk the talk and walk the walk practically and technically, probably the first two-thirds of his career in the field. So he has seen how can we leverage the technology to be more productive in the field and be safer in the field and deliver at a higher level of quality than our competitors. And I think him seeing that full view of the life cycle of a project is going to be huge in his success for construction technology.
He was promoted to Director of Construction Technology for all of Enerfab as a direct result of his nonstop, relentless pursuit of finding ways to do things better.
When I was assigned this job, I started by writing my own job description, and I had an 8-page document of all the things that I thought were worthy challenges and worthy assignments that we could start pursuing.
I think our employees are helping shape where we're going, what markets are attractive, how to continue to leverage what we're best at and what we've done for the legacy of our business while investing in the new markets and opportunities and technology. Those are going to converge, and that's really, really exciting for me and really exciting for the future of our business.
You know, and I went to a meeting with our upper management and was planning to go through this 8-page list, and the response was more, you know, Drew, we think that you're going to do the right thing, and we don't need to talk through your entire list. We trust you. And, you know, it feels like Enerfab has a lot of faith that I'm going to, you know, go after the technology projects that are the most fitting to our organization that'll help the most people across the company. We'll be right back.